Hello everybody, today we are going to see some important examples. Okay, already we have seen some theorems and properties. So today we are going to see how to use those properties and theorems in the examples. Okay, so today's first problem is P is the center of circle. Prove that angle XPZ is equal to 2 times angle XZY plus angle YXZ. Okay, so here first we will write here in given what is, it is not necessary to write given or to prove, directly we can write here solution, but now I am taking here what is given. P is the center of circle, P is the center of circle and XY, YZ are the chords, XY and YZ are the chords of circle. Chords of the same circle. Okay, what we need to prove? To prove, we are going to prove here 2 times angle XPZ, angle XPZ is equal to 2 times angle XZY plus angle YXZ. This is our target. This we need to prove. Okay, so this is also very simple proof. What we are going to think, see here, XY is the arc and XY subtend an angle with the center, that is XPY, and arc XY subtend the same one more angle on the remaining part of the circle, that is XZY, and we have seen the relation between this. Okay, so that I am taking here now in proof. In proof, what we are going to see, arc XY subtends angle XPY with center and angle XZY on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so we know the relation between this. When arc subtend an angle with the center, that angle is 2 times which is subtended by the same arc on the remaining part of the circle. So here we can say angle XPY is equal to 2 times angle XZY. Angle XPY is equal to 2 times angle XZY. Okay, so this is, I am saying here, this is first one. Okay, now we will think about the second. We will think about second, that is arc YZ. Okay, arc YZ subtends arc YZ subtend ZPY with the center, angle ZPY with center and angle ZXY, or we can say YXZ, angle YXZ on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so here we can say angle ZPY is equal to 2 times angle YXZ. ZPY is equal to 2 times angle YXZ. Okay, so this is, I am saying, second one. Okay, now we need to add them. By adding 1 and 2 means LHS, we will add in LHS, that is angle XPY plus angle ZPY is equal to 2 times angle XZY plus 2 times angle YXZ. Okay, so XPY plus ZPY means what? We can say XPZ, sum of this angle, this plus this, we can say angle XPZ. We got here our LHS is equal to, here we can take 2 common, what is going to remain in bracket, angle XZY plus angle YXZ. Okay, XZY, xzy plus angle yxz. That is our target. Understood? So here we have taken, we have used the property. The arc, we subtend angles with the center. Okay, that angle is 2 times the angle which is subtended by the same arc on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so this way, this property which we have learned, that property we need to use in the sums. Okay, our second problem is, two circles intersects each other at P and Q. From P, diameters PA and PB are drawn to the two circles. Show that AQB are collinear. AQB are collinear. This AQB are collinear, that is, that we need to show. Understood? So, here, first given things. What is given? Two circles intersect each other at P and Q. Okay. So, here, we will take the center, this center we will take O1 and this we will take O2. Understood? Two circles. Why we have taken circles centers? Because here they have told us from P, diameters PA and PB are drawn to the circles. PA is the diameter and PB is also diameter. Understood? So, what is given? PA and PB are the diameters. Are the diameters of both circles. Of both circles. Okay, are the diameters of two circles, of the diameters of circles. Okay, and what is given? Circles intersect each other at P and Q. Okay, P and Q. Understood? What we need to show here? To prove A point AQB, AQ and B are collinear. Collinear means what we need to show? Collinear means they are on the straight line. Understood? Straight line means we have to show AQB, angle AQB is 180 degree, straight angle. Okay, so if we are able to show angle AQB is 180 degree, then we can say A, Q and B are collinear points. Okay, so for that we need to do some construction. Okay, what we are going to do? We are going to join here P and Q. So, join point P with point Q. Okay, join P and Q. Okay. Here see, if you will observe here, this triangle PAQ, in triangle PAQ, this is the PA is the diameter. So, this is the semicircle. This due to diameter, the circles are circle is divided into two parts. So, we can say angle PQA is the in the semicircle. Angle PQA is in semicircle. Okay. So, here in proof, we can write PA is the diameter, okay, of circle CO-R, O1R, okay, we have taken here circle. So, PA is the diameter of the circle whose center is O1 and radius is R, okay. So, now we can say angle PQA is in semicircle. Okay, and the angle which is in semicircle, that is all, that angle is always 90 degree, right angle triangle. Okay, so that we have seen. So we can say angle PQA is equal to 90 degree. Angle PQA is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so this is I am saying first one. Now this circle, okay, we will see PB is the diameter. PB is the diameter of circle CO2R. Okay, this PB is the diameter of this circle. Understood? So here also we can say PQB is this angle is in the semicircle. So here we can write angle P PQB angle PQB is in the semicircle. Okay, so here we can write angle PQB is equal to 90 degree because angles in the semicircle are always right angle. So this first one we have and second one we have. So by adding first and second, so we can write here angle PQA plus angle PQB. Angle PQA plus angle PQB, we can write this is equal to 90 degree plus 90 degree by adding first and second. This addition will come angle AQB is equal to 180 degree. Okay, means angle AQB is a straight angle. Angle AQB is a straight angle. So we can say A, Q and B are on the same line. Understood? So here we can say angle. So point A, Q and B are collinear points. Okay, so which property we have taken here? Angles in the semicircle is always right angle. Okay, so here PQA is 90 degree, PQB is also 90 degree. Got it, everybody? Our next problem is O is the center of the circle. This is given. This is O is the center of circle. Prove that angle X plus angle Y is equal to angle Z. Okay, this we have to prove. And figure is given here. Figure is also given here. Okay, so here first given things. In given, we will write O is the center of circle. Okay, what we need to prove? Angle X plus angle Y is equal to angle Z. This we need to prove. Okay. So, see carefully. We are going to see now proof. Proof is easy, but need to see properly. See here, I am giving here names. This is I am saying angle 1. Okay. This I am saying angle 1. This is angle 2. This is angle 3. And this is I am saying angle 4. Okay, angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, if you observe your figure, this angle, triangle DYB or BDY, in triangle DBY, angle Y is the exterior angle for this triangle. Okay, so here I am taking that in triangle DBY, angle Y is the exterior angle. So by exterior angle property, exterior angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angles. So angle Y we can say, so angle Y is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2. Angle Y is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2. Okay. So this is angle Y. If I want angle 1, then I can say angle Y is minus angle 2. Okay, so this I am saying this is first one. Okay, now second thing, here we need to write by exterior angle property. Okay, so now second triangle we are going to think, that is BAE, in triangle BAE. Angle 3 is the exterior angle. Angle 3 is the exterior angle. Okay. Angle 3 is exterior angle. Means what? Angle 3 is equal to angle X plus angle 1. Angle 3 is equal to angle 1 plus angle X. Okay. This is I am saying second one. Okay, here also the same reason, exterior angle property, by exterior angle property. Okay, so now here if you will observe, we can say here angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. What is the reason of this? Because both the angles are in the same segment. Okay, segment is C, BOC, BOC, angle 2 and angle 3 are in the same segment, BOC. Okay, so angle 2 is equal to angle 3. So that I am taking here angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Angles in the same segment. And angles in the same segment are always equal, that we have seen. In the same segment. In the same segment. Angles in the same segment are always equal. Okay. So now we can say here angle Z. Z is the angle which is made by arc BC. Okay. So this angle and angle 2 or angle 3 are on the are made by the same arc. So I can see here angle Z is equal to 2 times angle 2. Angle Z is equal to 2 times angle 2. Okay, because BOC, which is angle made by arc BC. Okay, and by the same arc, one more angle is made on the remaining part of the circle, that is angle 2. So angle Z is equal to 2 times angle 2. Understood? So here we can say angle Z is equal to 2 times angle 3 also, because angle 2 and angle 3 are same, and angle 3 is also on the remaining part of the circle. So angle 2, Z is equal to 2 times angle 2. So this I am using here. Okay. So we can say angle Z is equal to 2 times angle 2 means what? Angle 2 plus angle 2. Angle 2 plus angle 2. So here we can say angle Z is equal to angle 2 plus angle 3, because angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. Angle 2 is equal to angle 3. So this angle 2 is replaced by angle 3. Okay. So we have both the values. Okay, angle 2 also we have and angle 3 also we have. Angle 3 we have and angle 2 from this we can write. Okay, so this is first, this is second. So here from first and second we can write angle Z is equal to angle 2 we can write angle Y minus angle 1. Okay, angle 2 is equal to angle 1 will move here, angle Y minus angle 1. So here I am replacing angle 2 by angle Y minus angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to angle 1 plus angle X. Angle 3 is equal to angle 1 plus angle X. Okay. So from this plus angle 1 and minus angle 1 will be cancelled. So what is remaining here? Angle Z is equal to angle Y plus angle X. Oh, so this we can write angle Z is equal to angle X plus angle Y, and which they are asking. Okay, angle Z is equal to angle X plus angle Y. Got it, everybody? So see here what we have used here, angles in the same segment, that is one property, and angle which is made by the arc with the center is twice the angle which is made by the same arc on the remaining part of the circle. So see carefully once again the whole solution and solve the same in your notebook. Okay, see here, our third problem is the chord ED is parallel to the diameter AC. Determine angle CED. Okay, see here, chord ED is parallel to the diameter AC. This is diameter AC and this is chord ED, which are both are parallel to each other. Understood? Then we have to find out angle CED. CED, this angle we need to find out. Okay, so this is very simple question based on the properties. Okay, so see here EC, arc EC, subtend two angles. Okay, in the same segment, means segment EC subtend two angles, angle EAC and angle CBE. Okay, so both the angles in the same segment are always equal. Understood? So that I am taking here angle CBE is equal to angle CBE is equal to angle CEAC, angle EAC. Okay, both angles are equal and 50 degree, because this angle is 50 degree and this is also 50 degree, because angles in the same segment, this is also 50 degree. Okay, so angles in the same segment, what is the reason? Angles in the same segment are always equal. Okay, this is EC is the one segment, and this one are both the angles are in the same segment and angles are equal. Okay, so CBE is equal to EAC is equal to 50 degree. Got it? Now what we can say Here, if you'll observe, AC is the diameter of the circle. AC is the diameter. AC is the diameter of circle. Circle, okay. So, angle AEC is in the semicircle. Is in the semicircle. Okay, semicircle. Okay, so we can say angle AEC is equal to 90 degree, because angle in the semicircle is always a right angle. So this is 90 degree. Angle, this angle is 90 degree. So now we can find out easily angle C. C means ACE. So we are going to use here now intra-angle ACE by angle sum property. That is angle ACE plus angle AEC plus angle EAC is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So angle ACE that we need to find out. So angle ACE, as it is I am taking, angle AEC that is 90 degree plus angle EAC is equal to 50 degree, is equal to 180 degree. Understood? So angle ACE is equal to 180 minus 90 plus 50. 90 plus 50 is equal to 140 degree. 90 plus 50 is 140 degree. So angle ACE is equal to 40 degree. Angle ACE is 40 degree. Okay. So here we got this angle ACE. This angle is 40 degree. But here one thing they have told us, that is ED is parallel to AC. ED is parallel to AC. So definitely angle ACE is equal to angle CED, because alternate interior angles are equal, because EC is a transversal. So we can say angle CED, which they are asking, angle CED is also 40 degree. This is 40, so this is also 40 degree. Okay, so we have seen all the more than one properties we have seen in the same example. Angles in the same segment are equal. Angle in the semicircle is right angle. Okay, and this already we have seen many times. So see carefully and solve this.